Drought's a serious concern as we go into our Labor Day weekend here. Voluntary water restrictions across the state. We're in a severe drought now for those areas that are in that brownish orange there, and that does include all of Cape May County, towns like Estelle Manor, towns like Morris River, even getting into Millville here. Occurs once every 10 to 20 years on average, this severe drought. And the last time we were in severe drought, either Ocean, Atlantic, Cape May, or Cumberland, or oppressive AC coverage area, was 2010 here. So this is fairly significant, and there's really no widespread rain in sight here. Let's take a look at our rainfall coverage here over the next couple of days. Likely dry until about Sunday night here, and that's only going to be isolated showers and storms during that time. So here's a look at our future cast. Let's take you through most of our Labor Day weekend here. Friday, good amount of sunshine to start. We'll get some clouds as we go into the afternoon here, but overall, I think it's a mostly a partly sunny day all in all here. We go into Friday night as the shore fills up one more time on a Friday night here. We're talking about a mostly cloudy sky. Saturday itself, I think a lot of this is high cloud cover that the sun shines through. We call it filtered sunshine, a little bit of a milky appearance to the sky here. Should be a dry day on Saturday. We'll get you into Sunday now. We're talking about noontime on Sunday. And you see some rain showers to our north here. They'll flare up maybe in a few spots, but I do believe that that is going to be hard to come by. I believe more than likely we're going to be dry on Sunday, but then Sunday night we get some rain showers to come in. This is now midnight on Monday itself on Labor Day. You see that rain working into the area, and there's just more rain around as we make our way into Monday morning, and that will continue into the afternoon. In fact, spread more as we go into the afternoon. So Monday at 6:30 p.m., rainfall totals looking like this. It's not a lot. Again, we are going to need 1 or 2 inches of rain in one shot, widespread, to start to dig out of this drought. This is good in the sense that it's not going to make things too much worse, but definitely not going to improve these drought conditions until we get a more widespread rain. All right, let's take a look at our daytime forecast for your Friday here. Temperatures in the 70s along the shore in that easterly wind, and we will be in the 80s as you make your way further inland. You're seeing sand forecast looking like this, 79 degrees for our high. That's in Atlantic City. Most places, again, 75 to 80. No rain to speak of. Water temps as warm as they could be here. Low risk for rip currents, wave heights 1 to 2 feet. So that is good news if you're heading into the water. If you're heading over to Atlantic City for the high school football game as they play Clearview, touchdown of an evening. Temperatures in the 70s during game time here. Winds northeast to the east. Blowing just around 10 miles an hour. And here's our Labor Day forecast. Again, looking dry here. And we're going to be seasonable as well. We're talking about mid-80s for highs inland. Over at the coast, we'll be just around 80 degrees for highs there. Overnight lows in the 60s. Very comfortable here for Saturday and Sunday. A little more humid Sunday rather than Saturday. But all in all, I think when we look at our shore summer weekend report card, the early look for this weekend, I'll go with a B+. Let's take a look at our inland 7-day forecast. So we'll get you to Monday, 85 degrees, spotty showers and storms. Tuesday, pretty much the same deal. Then we wane down our precipitation chances as we go into the middle part of next week. Local summers next week, of course. Those in these temperatures still staying summery here. Only one day looks to be below 80 degrees.